Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Seven Smushed Eggy channel. Today, we are going to talk about Jack Off Jill. Not all of their work, because I only know two albums, and I haven't gotten around to listening to all of them, but I want to pump out a review about something. And yeah, and I might go into some Scarling as well, because that's the same lead singer. So, you know, it's a little bit of a two-in-one. Also, I wanted to show my outfit. You can't really see it, but those are my socks. Woo! Okay, so the first album we need to talk about, one of two, is Sexless, Demons, and Scars. And this came out in 1997. I'm gonna give this one an A because I do like their other album a lot better. But I just really love the raunchiness. Like, the fucking titles are shit like Poor Impulse Control, Lolly Rot, Working With Meat, Cum Dumpster, Angels Fuck, and Devil's Kiss. I mean, you're getting some serious edge with these titles, but it's awesome. And she's not, the lead singer is not a really good vocalist. Like, she doesn't sing very well. But it doesn't really matter because the way that she executes it with this, like, raspy-ass voice. And she's also a pretty good screamer, though. This album is just a lot of fun. And it has, like, a lot of, like, darkness and stuff. And it's a little toxic. But, girl, same. Like, it's kind of, like, sometimes you just want to be a horrible person. And when you are, you just kind of listen to some Jack Off Jill in the background. And, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, right? My favorite songs on this album is My Cat, which is literally just an entire song about her cat, which she labels a pussy superstar. I mean, S-tier songwriting. I also like Horrible, because I just relate to that song. And Devil with the Black Dress On, that just reminds me of, like, my characters. Especially Refical. Y'all don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, but it's okay. You're cringe. And then I also like, Angels Fuck and Devil's Kiss, which will be very important for my other album review. So instrumentally, there's nothing really eye-catching or ear-catching. But, I mean, I don't care. It's just nice, heavy rock. And it's edgy as fuck, and it's fun. So, if you're looking for something with, like, lyrical or instrumental, like, genius, then this is not the band for you. But if you're just looking to, like, headbang and listen to some crazy-ass shit, then this is an awesome band for you. She does deal with a lot of, like, negative subjects. And I don't want to say she's glorifying them, but, like, she kind of is, but I mean, I just like that toxicity. So it's really up to you if you're into that. So this one's an A. We've come to the segment where I tell you something about myself. It's a little get to know you and a random object in my room right now. So let's start with the random object. This is my Kirby case. He's an AirPod case. I had to completely destroy my other one yesterday. I just got these yesterday. I had to cut him open because it was physically stuck and I put it backwards because I'm just really intelligent, honestly. Something I don't like about my features is that I have a fat face. Like, what is this? It makes me look like I'm really fat, but look, I'm not fat. Y'all don't think I'm fat, right? I will fucking never say that to me. What else is there to know about me? I don't really watch real life television. I usually watch anime and stuff because I'm a bit of a weeb, I guess. But I have been watching Breaking Bad only because I saw all the memes and I like it. So, okay, the next album is Clear Hearts and Gray Flowers. Yes, that is the album. This came out in 2000. I'm gonna give this one an SS. Well, actually an SS. Because this is when the lead singer and the band as a whole, it feels like they start to take the music a little more seriously. It's still got that edge. I mean, there's songs like Nazi Halo, Strawberry Gashes, Witch Hunt. So, I mean, it's still got that edge that Jack Off Jill fans are probably accustomed to by now. But the contents behind the songs have a lot more meaning, I feel like, and they're more developed and fleshed out. So that's why I'm ranking it a lot higher. And also, this album just means a lot to me personally, so. Sorry for my annoying ass fucking creaky ass chair, dude. Like, I do not know what to do about it. But, something that I thought was really cool about this album in particular is that it starts directly where the last song of the last album ended. Like, they literally connect together, and I've never seen that before. So I thought that, like, intro was so, like, cool. I don't know. That's something that really stuck out to me. Songs that I really like on this album are Vivica, When I Am Queen, Strawberry Gashes. Obviously, I literally covered those two. I just collectively like a lot of the songs better on here. Also, Love Song, her cover of The Cure, was really good. And after doing some research, apparently this was the last like official studio album. They didn't really have a long career, which is kind of sad, but
Random Object in My Room number 2, Gothic Hello Kitty. I've had this since I was like a kid. I don't know where I got it, but it's kind of awesome. And it's the best Hello Kitty plushie in the world. Okay, another fun fact about me. I like online shopping a lot. It's kind of my comfort, which is not really a good thing, but I don't know, like just getting myself new shit like gives me serotonin for like 2.5 seconds. And I mean, nothing wrong with that. I also, what else is a guilty pleasure? Blood on the Dance Floor. They're awful. But their songs make me laugh. And also Falling in Reverse is kind of a guilty pleasure. I play a lot of weird games like fucking Moshi Monsters. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to Scarling, which happened after Jack Off Jill. The lead singer, Jessica, what's her last name? What the fuck? I don't know her last name. But whatever, Jessica left Jack Off Jill because I think they were having some issues with other bandmates, and it's basically like her by herself. The album in question is Sweetheart Dealer. Holy fuck, can I talk?
I'm gonna be real with y'all. It's a bit of a downgrade in comparison to the last album or piece of work. It's not bad though. Like, I really do love The Last Day I Was Happy and Band-Aid Covers the Bullet Hole. But those are basically the only two songs that I'm super like, ooh, that was really cool. So I'm gonna have to give this one a C. Maybe a low B if I'm being generous. Actually, no, like, it's just a C. I only like two of the seven songs. And it's like barely an album too. There's only seven tracks. And the only reason why it is an album is because the last song is 7 minutes in length. So they were really reaching to get there. So this one's gonna have to be a C. But I do enjoy the two songs.
Random Object number 3, Pumpkin Spice Oreos. These taste like shit. It doesn't taste like pumpkin at all, and it was the biggest waste of money in my life. I just really like pumpkin stuff, okay, dude? Like, what can I say? Speaking of which, things that I like to eat, I love Asian food. Chinese and Japanese are my favorite. I've been craving Chinese food, but every time I've been to a Chinese place over the past few months, it's been absolute garbage. So I'm kind of like dying inside because I just want a really good egg roll that isn't like tastes like fucking shit, you know? Like, how do makes me infuriated. I like Mexican food too, but the toilet don't really be the toilet don't really be loving it after.
I love McDonald's, Taco Bell,
Chick-fil-A, basically most fast food places. Really love Pizza Hut. You can't out Pizza Hut. Yeah, like that's like the type of American food I like. I don't like any other American food though. Like I can't go to like a restaurant specific for American food because it makes me feel really sick and it's just like nasty to me. I don't know, it's like weird because I can't eat like an actual burger, but I can eat like a McDonald's one. I basically just really like food. Like I love candy, I love dessert, I love sweets. That's like the same shit. Soup, I'm a big soup fan. Polish food because I'm Polish. You know, like if there's food, I will be there. I'm a little picky though. I don't like sauces. The last Skarling album, it's not really an album, it's more of an EP that I've listened to, is Who Wants to Die for Art. I do not have much to say about this one. I'm probably gonna give it, oh my God, this is so harsh. I'm probably gonna give it a D. Nothing stuck out to me. I'm sorry. It was really boring. I like the cover art though. It's a bunny. Bungie.
The last item on today is my earring box. This is specifically for my earrings. I also have another box. This one is specific for necklaces, hair clips, rings, etc. I had to separate the two because it was getting a little crazy. I know you guys are wondering, when are you getting a new peepee? Well, I ordered a wee-wee, so there will be a wee-wee unboxing because I don't know what it's gonna be. It's gonna be a mixed bag, so. But that's my review on Skarling and Jack Off Jill. I hope y'all liked it. Bye.